got to. I'm Winston Essex. Welcome to Mansfield House. Now this is my friend, Samantha. Aren't you, Samantha? Yes, she's been here almost as long as I have. Beautiful creature. Feline. Almost regal, don't you think? It's hard to believe that she's a member of one of the most predatory species in the world. I mean, you'd have no reservations about bringing Samantha into your home. She'd be a welcome addition to any family. But no one would dream of bringing in one of her sister creatures, the tiger, the panther, the cougar. At least, not knowingly.
He's holding on. Oh! Oh, he's thrown! Bill Baker, it looks like he's going down.
Like that. I went to bareback, saddle bronc. That bull, he really spun me around.
That's what you get for showing off.
Yeah. Well, let me tell you, just two more seconds and I would have won the whole thing. The whole... Oh.
Come on. Huh? Let me take it.
All right. Oh. I know it's not broke. It's just sore, huh?
Yeah.
Hi, love.
Oh. Well, I think he's gonna live. It's a long way from his heart. It's all yours, Mariah.
Oh. I want to do better for you. Anybody buck me off.
Killer? He okay?
Yeah, he's gonna make it.
Who's the girl?
It's his wife. He looks surprised.
That I am. What's she like?
Well, she's nice enough. I don't know, Dump. There's something about it that gives me the creeps. And it isn't her wedding ring, either. It's as if she can see right through you.
He wanted to kill you. I hate him.
The bull? He's just doing what he's bred for.
I still hate him.
Hey, young fella.
Hey, I owe you a bill, Paul.
Oh, that's okay, that's okay. Listen, boy, when you gonna learn to stay off your head? Oh, sorry.
Yeah, if I landed my head, it wouldn't have
hurt so
much. Yeah, but... Dumpy.
Yeah.
Dumpy! Dumpy! Well, you old son of a gun, what are you doing in that outfit?
Oh, earning my keep, boy, earning my keep.
Why, isn't you riding anymore?
Oh, no, no. That got me a whole new career. But aren't we forgetting our manners here?
Oh, yeah. Dumpy Doyle, I'd like to meet my wife.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Holland.
Thank you, Mr. Doyle.
Yes. I can't believe he finally took the flight.
Yeah, well, I did. 2 weeks ago in Santa Fe. That's Mariah's hometown.
Santa Fe, my old stomping ground. I got a lot of friends down there. Mind if I ask the family name?
Ritter.
I knew a Jake Ritter down there, owned a saloon.
My father.
Oh, now, how about that? How about that? Ah, that a call?
Oh, we better attend to that. Come on,
sorry.
It was nice to meet you.
Well, I'll see you later.
So long, Dub. Hey, let's have a beer.
Yeah, careful.
Right. Hey, you know he was world champion.
Yes, be careful. Yes.
In
54. Well, she's her mother's daughter, all right. And just as beautiful.
You knew her mother?
For all my sins. That was a long time ago and well forgotten.
Well, there are no two ways about it. She sure is beautiful.
Well, for Danny's sake. I certainly hope her looks is all she got from that Hellcat.
Go away, I'm busy.
Hey, will you quit butting in?
He's jealous.
Well, you better tell him who the top cat is around here. Me. Hmm? Oh, yeah, that's right there, that's it.
Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever thought about giving it up?
Doing what? It's the only thing I know.
There's the ranch your father left you.
That's just a house and a barn.
We might be able to make something out of it. Be fun to try.
Mariah, you know I'd do anything for you, but just... don't ask me to quit. Not when I'm on top.
Do we wait till every bone in your body's been broken? Do you wind up in a pair of baggy pants like Dumpy Doyle?
Riding's the only thing that keeps me going. No good at anything else. I thought you understood that.
Dan, I'm sorry to be doing this to you. It's just that I'm scared. I've got this awful feeling that something terrible is going to happen. And today when you got hurt...
I'll tell you what. Let's just finish out the season. And if you still feel the same way, we'll go take a look at that ranch. How's that?
Don't pay any attention to me. My nerves are on edge lately. I haven't been sleeping well the last few nights.
Yeah, I heard you prowling around.
I can't imagine what's wrong.
Oh, I do. You just need a little good night's sleep and a little old Doc Paulus's.
Careful.
Sorry. Just a little of Dan Hollis's nerve tonic.
I love you, Dan. I'll never let anyone or anything hurt you.
Thank you.
saints preserve us.
Man, would you take a look at that?
Throat's torn open.
Hey, Dan, ain't that the bull you rode?
Yeah. What do you figure it was?
'Twas probably a cougar.
Nah, ain't no cat gonna come down out of the hills like that.
What about Big Red?
Nah, he's been dead for years.
Sure. He's been shot 100 times, if you can believe everything you hear.
Right.
That's no place for you.
I heard the commotion.
Where'd you get to?
I couldn't sleep, so I went for a walk.
A cougar. You got in the crowd with a bull. Honey, you're shivering. You're shaking like a leaf. Here, come sit over here.
What's the matter? I don't want my gal catching cold.
Hey, Dan.
Huh?
Take a look at this.
I'm fine. Go on.
Twas probably a cougar, all right.
Look at the size of those tracks.
Maybe it is Big Red.
Do you think he'll be back for more, Dan?
I don't know. But why wait? It's gonna be light soon.
Let's go.
Clint, you better put this bull out of its misery.
Right.
There's another one up at the north end.
All right, you go on up there and work your way back. You guys go with him, all right?
If he's up there, we'll flush him out.
You coming, Shiver?
No, I'm gonna stay with Dan.
Dark.
Well, depends on the company you keep.
I'm a married man, remember?
I wasn't sure that'd stop you.
You know something? Neither was I.
You're crazy about her, aren't you?
Guess it shows, huh?
It shows. Did she know about us? I mean, about before?
I think so. Sheila, I never had a chance to explain.
Hey, no explaining. We talked about that. No strings, remember?
You know, some old boy's gonna hit the jackpot when he gets you.
Yeah, if he doesn't run out of nickels first. Danny?
Huh?
She ever talk about her background?
Parents, you mean?
Yeah, she mentioned her mother.
Well, just that some guy ran off with her when Mariah was just a kid. Why?
It was just something Dumpy said.
Dumpy? What'd he say?
Well, just that Mariah's mother was kind of wild, and he hoped she wouldn't take after her.
What's he going around talking about Mariah like that for?
Oh, he didn't mean anything.
I don't care. It's none of his business. I don't like that.
Oh, come on.
No, wait, you stay here.
Thank you. Sheila, are you all right?
Are you all right?
What happened?
Big Red, attack Sheila.
It wasn't Big Red. It was a she-cat. And another thing, Dumpy, I've never known a cat not to be afraid of fire. Didn't even phase this one. Tell you, I had the darndest feeling that cat had it in for me. Me, personally.
Here, let's don't be dwelling on it like this.
You're right. Boy, it was scary.
Good morning to you, Mariah.
Morning, Dumpy.
Well, isn't that a fine-looking animal? Did you, hear what happened to Sheila?
Yes, I did. It's a shame. But I'm glad she's all right this morning.
Say, that's a nasty-looking burn you got there.
I burned it on the stove.
They say the best thing for a burn like that is a lot of ice.
Hey, Dumpy. Dumpy.
Danny?
Stay away from my wife.
How's that again, boy?
You heard me. Stay clear of Mariah.
What's eating you, boy?
It's you and that big mouth of yours. You've been asking a lot of foolish questions.
We were just having a nice little chat. You mind telling me what this is all about?
Well, the next time I catch you snooping around, I'm going to bust that nose of yours.
Well, I'd like to see you try that, Dan.
You would.
Dan!
Stay clear of Mariah. You hear me? I got to work my horse.
Dan. Dan. Dan, are you all right? Oh, Dan.
Acts like he's got a burr under his side.
Ow! Ooh, so hard.
Dumpy, what is it?
Danny's horse.
I'm going after that cat.
Anybody going with me?
Let's go. Come on.
Competition.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, it's as clear as day. My bride's mind is off somewhere else. Now, it couldn't be another fella, could it?
I had a terrible dream last night, that's all.
Oh, why don't you tell me about it? Huh? Huh?
Mariah. Mariah. Hon. What are you doing out here? What's going on?
Take me away, please.
Love, I thought we had that all settled.
Take me away, Dan, now. Your ranch, anywhere. Just get me out of here before it's too late.
Too late? But for what?
How can I explain? Dan, something terrible is happening to me. If I don't get away from here, I think I'm going to lose my mind.
Love, I know you've been upset over the killings. You haven't slept. But as soon as we catch Big Red,
Dan,
it'll be all over.
It's not Big Red. It's me. The bull, Sheila, your horse. I'm the one responsible.
You're not making any sense.
Don't you see? They all had one thing in common. You. They all wanted to hurt you. Or take you away from me. And I'll never let that happen.
What are you trying to tell me?
Dan, I think I'm haunted. Possessed.
Honey, that's crazy. It was Big Red behind all those attacks. I told you, as soon as we catch...
When you went out last night, to kill Big Red, you didn't even see him, did you?
No, he gave us a slip, but we'll catch him tonight.
He was here at Dan. With me.
Cat dragged in.
I came over to patch things up. I don't know what. I guess I got a little steamed up when I heard you talking about Mariah. I owe you an apology.
I accept it.
To old friendship.
You're not riding today?
No. Dumpy, how well did you know Mariah's mother?
Why, what happened?
She keeps telling me she's, possessed.
It's true, then.
What's true?
Here, have another drink. You're gonna need it. She called herself Serena. The look of her was enough to make a man wonder. When I was around her, I didn't know my own name. When I was away from her, my life was purgatory. May God have mercy on my soul. Run off together, we did. But not before she set fire to Jake's saloon.
Her own husband?
Yeah. I didn't know about it till much later. By then, the damage was done.
It's no wonder Mariah doesn't talk about her much.
I doubt she ever knew. She couldn't have been 5 years old at the time. She don't even know who I am.
Well, what happened to her?
I killed her.
What?
Oh, not in the ordinary sense, man. But just sure as I'm sitting here, was my hand done the deed. She tried to warn me. I just laughed at her. I kept telling her it's nothing but superstition. By then, I was getting fed up with her lying and her cheating. Then, when I heard what she'd done to Jake, that finished it. I left her that very night. Never set eyes on her again.
What? How come? How can you say you killed her?
I was about 5 miles out of town, riding west towards Albuquerque. There was a full moon. Then, out of nowhere, this great cougar appears. Well, my horse rears. Down I go. Before I manage to get a bead on her, this great cat pounces on me. I don't remember much after that, except I managed to pull the trigger. And, that cat ran off with my bullet in her.
Mariah's mother?
They found her the next morning. With a bullet in her heart.
Dumpy, you can't... Well, you can't expect me to believe a woman can turn herself into an animal.
You believe anything you want, lad. But I didn't make up this. Catch a hurt she-cat in the dark.
What happened to you out there, Danny?
I got something in my eye.
For you. What you told me, it can't be true. We saw that she-cat up in the hills. And Clint winged her. So you see?
I got no use for him anymore.
But that's your old...
You'll be needing a good horse. I know where you're going, Danny. What you must be doing. Now be careful.
Of what?
Of her.
Thank you, Danny. See you.
Like I told you, it ain't no palace.
It's fine.
It's him.
It'll always be him. Don't you see? He followed me. He'll never let me go.
They're gone, aren't they?
Yes, to his ranch, I think.
For good?
Yes.
Why?
That's their business, love.
It's our business, too, if we love him.
the only way.
Hot, huh? Thanks.
are you doing?
I should clean up.
Oh, come on, that can wait.
Well, it'll be dark soon.
Huh. I can't. Not again.
We have to.
I'm gonna set you free once and for all.
Dan, please don't go. Dan, please.
I've got to.
No! No! Post.
What happened? Who did this to you?
Ever since we got here, he changed. He beats me, chains me up, leaves me in here all night.
Danny?
Oh, Sheila, I'm so frightened. I don't know what it'll do next.
I can't believe it. Not Danny.
I swear, it's true.
Where is he now?
Gone. Please help me, Sheila. He's got a gun. I must stop him.
Is there a phone in the house? You stay here. I'll get help.
Thank you. Dan.
Fortunately, I'm not too superstitious. Samantha and I will remain good friends, as we've always been. Still, there are times when I look into her eyes and I experience just the slightest twinge. A vague uncertainty. Probably just my imagination, but... shoo, go on. Some scenes from our next adventure on Ghost Story.
The girls, the murder victims, all died of throat wounds.
Imagine what Thorpe is going to do if he ever finds out we dug up a grave and killed a corpse?